Hi guys and welcome to my channel. In today's video we will see how to dual boot CachyOS and Windows 10 or Windows 11 without errors. We will also learn how to add Windows to the CachyOS boot menu and choose which operating system to boot by default. I tried to make it useful and interesting for you, so let's get started. CachyOS is a Linux distribution that is rapidly gaining popularity. Based on Arch Linux, this operating system is focused on performance and security, with optimizations for various types of hardware. Let's start by downloading the CachyOS ISO image from the official distribution page. Go to the download page. From here you can choose between two versions, CachyOS Desktop Edition and CachyOS Handheld Edition. The desktop edition is optimized for everyday and professional use on personal computers. This version supports various desktop environments such as KDE Plasma, GNOME, XFCE, and many others. It also includes tools for performance optimization, security, and in my opinion, you will not miss anything. The handheld edition is optimized for devices like Steam Deck, Lenovo Legion Go, and more. It includes pre-installed gaming tools and support for game mode, so it is a gaming version. For this video, I will be using CachyOS Desktop Edition, but if you are a gamer, try Handheld Edition. Select one of the options to download the version you need and wait for the download to complete. For this video, I will be using Rufus to create the installation USB, but you can also use Balina Etcher or my favorite tool Ventoy. I will include links on how to create Ventoy on Windows or Linux in the description of this video so you can give it a try. When the download is complete, go to the Rufus page and download the version for your computer. Rufus is a Windows program that allows you to create a bootable USB drive from an ISO file. It does not require installation in the traditional sense, as it is portable software. This means that you can simply run the program without installing it on your computer. Once the download is complete, go to the Downloads folder, open Rufus, and insert the USB drive. Remember that you don't have to keep Rufus. You can just use it and then delete it. In Rufus, first make sure you have selected the correct USB drive under Devices. Remember that all data on it will be erased, so back up any important files. Click Select and select the CachyOS ISO file from the folder where it was downloaded. You can also change the partition scheme of the USB drive from MBR to GPT, or vice versa. Frankly speaking, in this case it doesn't matter at all. When you are ready, press Start, confirm the pop-up windows and the creation of the installation USB will begin. Wait for the process to complete. I would like to clarify that the creation time in the video is not real and I have shortened it. When everything is ready, close Rufus. As I told you, you can now delete Rufus if you do not need it. The same applies to the CachyOS ISO file, so you can delete it too. The next step is to free up disk space for CachyOS. We will do this using Windows Disk Manager. Open Windows Disk Manager and find the partition you want to shrink. I will shrink the C partition, but you can use another partition if you have one. Right-click on the C partition and select the Shrink Volume option. In the next window, enter how much space you want to free up in megabytes. Keep in mind that 1 gigabyte is equal to 1024 megabytes. I will use 80,000 MB, which is just under 80 gigabytes. After entering the desired value, click Shrink. The shrinking process may take some time depending on the size of the partition and the amount of data on it. When everything is ready, close Windows Disk Manager, insert the installation USB, and restart your computer. Immediately after the restart, enter your BIOS. If you don't know how, search the internet for which button is responsible for activating the BIOS for your computer. What we will do here is to put the CachyOS installation USB in the first place as the boot priority. The second thing we need to change is to turn off Secure Boot, if of course it is enabled. And finally, make sure that CSM support is enabled. When you are done, save the changes and after the reboot the CachyOS installation USB will boot. Now you need to select one of the boot options in the boot menu of the CachyOS installation USB. The first one, CachyOS, which supports Intel, AMD, and NVIDIA graphics cards with a series lower than 20. You will need to choose the second option, CachyOS with NVIDIA open source module if your card is NVIDIA with a series higher than 20. The third option, CachyOS legacy hardware, which you will need to use if you have outdated hardware or are having problems with the graphics drivers. So, select the correct option for your hardware and press Enter. Now you need to wait for CachyOS to load. Once the installation USB has loaded, you will be presented with the CachyOS welcome window. Before starting the installation, make sure you have an internet connection. If everything is fine with the internet connection, you can run the installer. Now you will need to choose the most suitable bootloader for you. Grub is a boot manager for legacy and UEFI systems. It is a bit slower than the others but is extremely flexible and powerful, suitable for complex configurations and outdated systems. Systemd Boot Manager is simple and perhaps the fastest, ideal for UEFI systems. Refind is a user-friendly GUI, great for dual boot and UEFI systems. Choose AI SDK Refind if you are a developer and create AI-based applications. I will choose Systemd Boot Manager, which is suggested by default. Select the language in which you want to install CachyOS. Now specify the region you are in. Select your keyboard language and layout. Now we have come to the most important part of the installation where we have to specify what type of installation we want. Based on the experiments I have done on all the options, I recommend that you do not use the install alongside option because there is a high probability that Windows will not boot. Replace partition will also not work and the installation will fail. You can use erase disk if you want to use only CachyOS on your computer. Manual partitioning is the method I will use because I want the installation to be successful and keep Windows. Let's continue. Check manual partitioning and click Next. At the top of this window, first make sure you have selected the correct drive in the storage device field. I don't check this because I only have one drive installed on my computer. What you need to do here is to create two new partitions from the free space you created with Windows Disk Manager. In fact, incorrect disk partitioning is the most common reason why the CachyOS installation process fails, and that's why I want to explain why it is so. The EFI partition that Windows created is very small, it is 100 megabytes in size. However, this is not enough for CachyOS because it needs over 2 gigabytes of space to install the boot files, and for this reason the EFI partition overflows and the installation fails. Let's continue with creating a new EFI partition. Select the empty space and click Create. Now, enter 2500 megabytes on size. The minimum requirement is 2048 megabytes, but we will make it a little bigger because after the installation we will add the Windows boot files here. For file system select FAT32. The mount point should be /boot. You can leave the file system label empty. And finally check boot and flags. When you are done, click OK and the EFI partition will appear with the others. Let's continue with creating the second partition, which we will use for the operating system. Select the empty space and click Create. For size, I will use all the remaining free space. For file system, I will choose BTRFS, but you can also use ext4. I will set the mount point to only slash, which is basically everything on one partition. Leave the file system label blank and do not check anything in flags. On the screen, you will see that I checked root in flags, but it is not necessary. This is a mistake that I made out of habit. This flag was necessary on old legacy systems, which, as you will see, will not harm the installation, but I repeat that it is not necessary. When you are done, click OK and the partition will be created. We are done with partitioning the disk and can continue with Next. On the next screen, you need to choose the desktop environment you want to use. CachyOS offers 17 desktop environments. Choosing a desktop environment for your Linux distribution is just as important as choosing the distribution itself. If you are new to Linux, you may want to choose a more intuitive and easy-to-use environment like GNOME or Cinnamon. If you have an older and less powerful computer, lightweight environments like LXDE, LXQT, or XFCE may be better options. KDE Plasma offers more customization options, and if you like to customize your environment, this may be important to you. GNOME and KDE, for example, offer a wide range of applications and integrations that can make your daily life easier. I hope you have chosen your favorite desktop environment so that we can continue. On the next window, you can select additional software to be installed. I have selected the KDE desktop environment, but you can also choose to install some of the packages that are specific to other desktop environments, such as the GNOME Software Center. What I will do here is set up the installation of two more desktop environments. I will do this because in the research for this video I came across many comments and complaints that when you install more than one desktop environment on CachyOS, the installation fails. Therefore, I will mark for installation the new Cosmic desktop environment on PopOS and the UKUI desktop environment. You do not need to do this unless you are hesitant and want to try more than one desktop environment. When you are done, click on Next to continue. On this window, you will create your account. Enter the necessary data, such as your name, the username you will use to log in, and the computer name with which your computer will be identified when sharing on the network. Choose a password for the user account, and if you wish, you can enter a different password for the root account, which will be created anyway, and as you will see, you will need it. I do not recommend you use the automatic login to the account, not only because you will be more vulnerable, but also because after each login, you will be asked to enter the password for your wireless internet, as well as some applications that have stricter security rules. When you are done, click on Next to continue. The next window will show you all the settings you have selected, including the changes that will be made to your disk. If you decide to abort the installation now, no changes will be made to your computer. I hope you will continue with me and complete the installation process. The CachyOS installer will warn you one last time that the changes will be applied. Click Install now and the installation process will begin. Wait for the installation process to complete. It took me about 7 minutes, but your time may vary. The installation time you see is not real. When the installation is complete, check the Restart Now box and click Done. Don't forget to remove the CachyOS installation USB before turning the computer back on, because it will boot again. Now CachyOS has taken the first place in the boot priority. The fact that you do not see Windows in the CachyOS boot menu is normal, and as I promised you at the beginning of this video, we will add it in a moment. Let's boot CachyOS for the first time. You are currently seeing the actual CachyOS boot time, which is around 12 seconds. At the login window, you can choose which desktop environment to load if, of course, you have more than one installed. Frankly speaking, I was not satisfied with the UKUI desktop environment and therefore I do not recommend installing it. As for Cosmic, it is still under development and in the alpha version you may encounter errors. However, the stability is high and I was satisfied. Let's go back to the Plasma environment and add Windows to the CachyOS boot menu. At login we are greeted by the CachyOS welcome, so be sure to familiarize yourself with the features CachyOS offers. I will do that later, so let's continue. What surprised me about CachyOS is that there was no partition manager installed by default. So the first thing I will do is install the KDE partition manager. I will use the Octopi graphical package manager to install the KDE partition manager. Search for partition manager in the search box. Right-click on the latest version of the partition manager, select install and then click the apply button. Confirm the next window and you will be asked to enter your password. Then KDE partition manager will be installed. We need the KDE partition manager to mount the Windows EFI partition. I am doing it this way for new and inexperienced users, but if you are experienced with the terminal and know how, you can do it without using the partition manager. Not to forget, for GNOME users, GNOME Disks does a perfect job and you don't need to install the KDE partition manager. When you are ready, launch the partition manager. Enter the user password. Find the Windows EFI partition. It is located at the beginning of the disk on the left. Its size is 100 MB and the file system is FAT32. Right-click on the partition and select Edit Mount Point. Go to Select and choose the mount folder to be MNT. Then press OK and confirm to save the changes. Right-click again on the partition and select Mount. Now the EFI partition is mounted in the MNT folder. The next step is to log out of the user account and log into the root account. On the login screen, select Other. In the user field, enter root and then use the password for the root account if you set a different one during installation. Now open Dolphin File Manager, select the CachyOS partition from Devices and open the MNT folder. Open the EFI folder and copy the Microsoft folder. Go back to the CachyOS system directory and open the boot folder. Here you will find the EFI folder again. Open it and paste the copied Microsoft folder into it. When you are done, close Dolphin File Manager and restart your computer. Now you can see Windows in the CachyOS boot manager. Notice the check mark on the left side of Windows 11. This means that it is the operating system that will boot by default. If you want to change this, simply highlight CachyOS and then press the D key on your keyboard. This will indicate that you want CachyOS to be the default operating system. Let's boot into Windows to check if everything is okay. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you found it useful and interesting. If you liked it, don't forget to press the like button and subscribe to my channel so you don't miss new videos. If you have any questions or ideas for future topics, leave your comments below. Your opinion is important to me and helps me improve my content. See you in the next video. Have a nice day and take care.